Good evening, I'm Keisha Buss with the CTV News Update. With more than 1 million Marylanders expected to travel this Thanksgiving holiday, AAA has a message for you. Pack your patience. The Auto Club expects almost 72,000 people to fly and more than 990,000 people to hit the roads. At the airport, it's urging you to give yourself enough time to get through security checkpoints. The Auto Club also wants you to make sure your car is travel ready.
You can go to any of our AAA car care centers to have a free inspection before hitting the road. Schedule an appointment to do that. We expect to probably come to the aid of over 6,700 AAA members over the Thanksgiving Day holiday weekend. So it's really important that you make sure that your car is ready to hit the roads as well.
Nationally, more than 53 million Americans are projected to travel this holiday. We've all heard about how climate change can affect areas along the shoreline. Annapolis is one of such areas suffering from rising sea levels and frequent flooding. It can cause catastrophic damage and lead to huge economic losses. While Maryland still debates how to put a statewide climate action plan into place, local jurisdictions are taking the lead to develop their own plans. Prince George's County is currently asking for public input on its climate action plan.
It's a blueprint for how we can produce more foods here locally so that we don't have to necessarily truck those foods in from across the country and thereby create more emissions. If you're interested in solar installations, there are a number of recommendations as to how the county government and residents and businesses can work together to make solar installations on homes more affordable. If you're interested in electric vehicle, there are recommendations in the plan about how we can help each other make those acquisitions of electric vehicles more affordable. The plan also really looks at equity, that we have to do more to help communities that don't necessarily have those readily available resources take advantage of the opportunities which the plan will open up.
The public comment period closes on December 1st. To look at or comment on the county's climate action plan, log on to PrinceGeorge'sCountyMD.gov. Prince George's police are investigating a fatal two-car crash in Upper Marlboro. It happened this morning and forced officers to shut down South Osborne Road. The two motorists involved in the collision were taken to the hospital. An adult male driver died of his injuries. The second victim suffered from non-life-threatening injuries. Meantime, a woman was shot on a sidewalk in District Heights this morning. Police say they responded to the 2100 block of County Road around 7:45. They found the victim suffering from multiple gunshot wounds. She is currently in the hospital with life-threatening injuries. Anyone with information about this case is urged to call police. Heads up to Metrorail riders, reduced service will continue through the end of the year. The reductions began following a derailment which forced Metro to take the 7000 series train out of service. Officials aren't sure when normal operations will resume. You're watching CTV News. I'm Keisha Budd. Still to come, the arts community puts out a call to youth poets. Stay with us.
Mr. Rogers said, look for the helpers. You can always find people who are helping. Thank you to all the first responders who put their lives in danger to help us. When my brothers and sisters and mom and dad and grandpa and grandma need them, we look out for the helpers because they look out for us.
Thank you, first responders.
You know, there's a rewarding feeling you get when you do, like, hey man, I just, you know, we carried a lady out of fire, you know?
This is what I signed up for as a first responder, and this is what I love to do. And I'm going to continue going to work day in and day out and providing help to those that need it.
Thank you, first responders.
Thank you, first responders. We need you. We wanted to let you know how much we appreciate you.
Thank you, first responders!
Thank you, first responders!
Love you!
Be safe, look after yourself, and look after one another. Thanks.
Welcome back. Maryland marks a major milestone in getting seniors vaccinated. The governor says 99.9% of seniors have received at least the first dose of the vaccine. Currently, booster shots are available for adults in the state. More than 861,000 booster shots have been administered. Almost half of the state's eligible seniors have gotten the booster dose. Here are the latest COVID-19 numbers for our area. The state health department has identified 832 new cases since yesterday. The county's positivity rate is at 2.68%. 8 Marylanders have died of the disease since yesterday. 581 remain in the hospital. If you need to get a COVID-19 test before visiting family this Thanksgiving, listen up. The county has opened up the Bunker Hill Fire Station as a testing site. Residents can come and get tested today through Friday. The fire station will be open 9:30 a.m. until 5:30 in the evening. Appointments are not required. President Joe Biden's push to get federal workers vaccinated seems to be working. The Associated Press reports that more than 90% of federal workers have received at least one dose of the COVID-19 vaccine. The president's deadline for all federal workers to get the vaccine is today. Biden's mandate impacts more than 3.5 million employees. 5% of federal employees have requested exemptions. Meantime, a local arts organization is seeking young people for its upcoming Youth Poet Laureate program. CTV caught up with the executive director of the Dialect of Prince George's County at Arts Tenation today. That's an art and performance venue at National Harbor. He says Dialect Prince George's is looking for young poets, rappers, and storytellers between 13 and 19 years old for its 2022 program, which is aimed at speaking truth to power.
We're trying to find young people who are comfortable speaking to adults. Essentially, we want to give them a seat at the table where their opinions and their perspectives can be heard artistically. Many times they're not comfortable speaking and dialoguing with adults, so we're giving them a chance to do so in their words.
The deadline to upload your poetry or videos is Saturday, December 4th. Go to dialect-usa.com for more information. And coming up later on the news, the Bowie State Bulldogs tackle another opponent to advance in the NCAA playoffs. That story and more after the break.
We ain't done yet. We ain't done yet. We're going all the way. We're going all the way.
Not done yet. Four more.
I'm ambitious. I will not hide it.
We will not hide it.
We embrace ambition.
Women are made to be ambitious.
I will dream big.
Big, without hesitation.
We will take risks.
Not live in fear.
We will rise together.
Rise above the negativity.
No longer will ambition in a woman
be seen as a negative.
Be persistent.
Don't apologize.
Never give up on your goals and dreams.
We will model ambition
for our daughters
and our sons.
I will help women around the world,
the whole world,
to succeed.
You have to persevere.
Women are tough,
strong,
powerful. We have got to be a part of this conversation.
Ambition is feminine.
Ambition is empowering.
Ambition is not a dirty word.
I can think of a lot of dirty words.
Ambition's not one of them.
Ambition is sexy.
Ambition is very sexy.
What's your ambition?
To help women build empires.
Help more women run for office.
Empower women financially.
Help women entrepreneurs.
Create powerful images.
Change people's lives.
Fight gender stereotypes.
Equality for all.
For all of us. To lean in together.
To transform societies.
Change the world.
Take the stigma out of the word ambition.
Own your power.
Own your power.
Own your drive.
Own your dreams.
Own your dreams.
No judgments.
No judgments.
We own it.
Take the pledge.
Take the pledge.
Take the pledge.
Embrace ambition.
Embrace ambition.
Will you?
Thank you for staying with us. While almost everyone loves donuts, now you can order a hot batch straight to your front door. It's all thanks to these two women, Stephanie Risk and Tiki Aiku. They founded Galaxy Donuts earlier this year. These two friends are whipping up flavors from lemon orange poppy seed to peanut butter and chocolate. The delicious treats are available for delivery if you live in Greenbelt, Beltsville, College Park, Riverdale, and Mount Rainier.
our reception, it's overwhelming. People, we thought they were good, right? But just because we have the same flavor palette doesn't mean everybody else is going to like it. And so what we're really excited about is that through COVID and the most safe way, we've been able to bring a lot of joy to folks.
You really spend a lot of time recipe testing. So the flavors that you're getting in a Galaxy Donut are in the batter, in the glaze, in the toppings, it goes all the way through. So it's not just like some places that have one kind of donut or two kind of donuts and you put all kinds of different stuff on top of it. It's all the way through that.
The donuts are also available for pickup in Greenbelt. To place your order, visit galaxydonuts.space. A sudden surge of goals near the end of a championship soccer game gives Northwestern High School a state title. The team beat Northwest High 3-2 in the 53rd minute after initially trailing in the game. The win is Northwestern's third state title and the first since 1995. Only one other Prince George's team has made it to the state finals in the 26 years since Northwestern last qualified. Former Maryland Senator Victor Ramirez has been coaching the team for the last 5 years.
I saw a community come together. I saw the Hyattsville area come together. And then ultimately, when we got to the finals, when we were the only Prince George's County school still in the tournament, you start to receive emails and texts saying, all of Prince George's is behind you, go get it. And so to me, that was a sense of pride. And I'm so proud of my boys because I feel like this doesn't happen every day. Not being able to play last year, I think, built something in them. It created a sort of energy within them to say that they're not going to take anything for granted anymore.
Northwestern High School held a special recognition luncheon this afternoon for the newly crowned champions. Congrats to the Bowie State University football team. The Bulldogs win in round one of the NCAA Division II playoffs. The Bulldogs scored a 31-10 victory Saturday over the Lenoir Ryan Bears. Quarterback Jerome Johnson ran for two touchdowns, giving Bowie State the early 7-0 lead with the 65-yard run to the end zone in the first quarter. The Bulldogs defense forced three turnovers on the day, scoring on a 70-yard interception by Tevin Singleton in the second quarter and sophomore Jonathan Ross getting a sack and forcing a fumble to stop the Bears on the goal line before halftime. Running back Khalil Wilkins added a 15-yard touchdown run in the fourth quarter to put the game away for good. Wilkins and Johnson each rushed for over 100 yards in the game, and the senior quarterback had this to say about his two touchdown runs.
The first one was an inside zone read, seeing it in flat footed, and I knew I could beat a defensive tackle around the edge, so took my chances, went around the edge, ran up the field. The second one, I just read the linebacker. Whatever he did, I did the opposite.
Our guys have been playing well all season defensively. And, we have a bend but don't break mindset. You know, just because the team gets on in the red zone on the one-yard line, that don't mean we had to give up a touchdown. And I think that showed today, looking at the stats, I mean, they have more yards than us and everything, but we have more points. That's what it's all about, keeping them out the box, keeping them out the end zone, and for us to score more than the other team does. You put the defense in a bind when you have a guy like Jerome that can run the ball. He can still throw the ball, and he had a running back like Khalil. You can't stop all three. You know, and Jerome did a good job recognizing what they were doing early on and pulling the ball himself when he needed to and giving it to Khalil and the other. Also throwing the ball downfield. Didn't have a lot of yards, but we were able to pick up a few first downs that were clutch in passing situations.
If it's there, why not take it? I ain't going to force nothing not there, so I got the ability to run. I watch a lot of Lamar Jackson on TV, so. So, yeah, plays a big part of it.
Bowie State will host Newberry at 1 p.m. Saturday at Bulldog Stadium. Let's get a quick check on our three-day weather forecast. Tonight, mostly cloudy and cold with a low around 28 degrees. Tuesday and Wednesday, sunny with daytime temps near the low to mid 40s. Thursday, mostly sunny with a high near 56. And now for the community calendar. Calling all Laurel residents, officials are looking for volunteers to form a Juneteenth Executive Planning Committee. The group will plan the first annual community-wide Juneteenth celebration. There are 12 spots to fill. Citizens who are interested in serving on the committee are asked to send a resume to the address listed on your screen. And that wraps up our CTV newscast. Join us again tomorrow at 4:30. I'm Keisha Butts. Have a good night.